Students, in today's video, we will study about the English Education Act of 1835 and Wood's Dispatch of 1854. As we had studied earlier, that Thomas Babington Macaulay and James Stuart Mill, they promoted the teaching of Western education in India, and Thomas Babington Macaulay was one of the most outspoken and influential of such group of people who laid emphasis on promotion of Western education. He saw India as an uncivilized country that needed to be civilized. No branch of Eastern knowledge, according to him, could be compared to what England had produced. And when Thomas Babington Macaulay was appointed the chairman of the Committee of Public Instructions, he emphasized upon the need to teach in English medium with full force. He felt that knowledge of English would allow Indians to read some of the finest literature the world had produced, and he laid stress on Western literature and science to be the important subjects of study for all Indians. Teaching of English could thus be a way of civilizing people, changing their taste, values and culture. And following Macaulay's views, the English Education Act of 1835 was introduced. All educational funds were to be spent on English education. And English replaced Persian as the court language. Printing of English books was made free and were made available at very low prices. So he believed in the theory of filtration, according to which the knowledge of Western education would reach the masses gradually through the English educated Indians. In 1854, the Court of Directors of the East India Company in London sent an educational dispatch to the Governor General in India, and Charles Wood, the President of the Board of Control, formulated a scheme of future education in India. It came to be known as the Wood's Dispatch. It meant to provide a coordinated system of education on an all-India basis, and it was the first comprehensive plan for the spread of education in India and was considered as the Magna Carta of English education in India. Some of the main recommendations of the Wood's Dispatch were like, teaching of Western education would be the main aim of the government education policy. Medium of instruction in higher classes was to be in English language. And mother tongue was adopted as the medium of instruction in the primary schools in villages. And it made provisions for setting of vernacular primary schools in villages, Anglo vernacular high schools and affiliated colleges at the district level. Scholarships and awards were introduced. It emphasized vocational education and education of women. It introduced grant in aid policy and gave due importance to Indian literature, culture and philosophy. There was emphasis on training of teachers and stipends to the poor and deserving students. And it made provisions for setting off universities, and thus as a result the universities at Calcutta, Bombay and Madras were set up in 1857. And following the 1854 dispatch, several measures were introduced by the British. Education departments of the government were set up to extend control over all matters regarding education. And then we can say that attempts were also made to bring about changes within the system of school education. And then there was a demand for moral education. The argument for practical education was strongly criticized by the Christian missionaries in India in the 19th century. The missionaries felt that education should attempt to improve the moral character of the people, and morality could be improved only through Christian education. And over the 19th century, missionary schools were set up all over India. But they also feared, the British East India Company feared that any strong attack on local custom practices, beliefs and religious ideas might enrage the native opinion. The practical benefits of the Woods Dispatch, or you can say the advantages of Woods Dispatch, were like, apart from making provisions for education on an all India basis, the Woods Dispatch also served the practical purposes of the company's officials. It stated that learning English will be an advantage to the Indians for the trade and commerce. It said that it would enable Indians to recognize the advantages that flow from the expansion of trade and commerce and make them see the importance of developing the resources of the country. The British also had an ulterior motive to promote English language and English culture. Introducing the Indians to European ways of life would change their taste and desire and create a demand for British goods among the Indians, because now the Indians would start appreciating the European way of living and buy things that were produced in Europe. European learning would improve the moral character of Indians. It would make them more truthful and honest, and thus supply the company with civil servants. Some of the demerits of the Woods Dispatch. The Woods Dispatch could not manage the education system well. Mass education did not become a reality. The grant in aid did not work well, as there was paucity of funds and irregularity of the release of funds. Paucity means insufficient amount. It also neglected the education of girls. No scientific or technical advancement was made in education. Mass education was neglected in the sense, as it required regular classes and regular payment of fees, it could not be afforded by the average Indians. The Indians who received modern education gradually began to blindly follow the European ideas, thoughts and literature. They failed to acknowledge the contribution of Indians in the field of literature, arts, architecture and science, and thus they became aliens in their own country. But despite its drawbacks, the Western education proved beneficial for the Indians in many ways. And in the next video, we will study about the efforts of Indian nationals towards development of education. Please answer these questions in your copy and read the chapter. Thank you, children.